फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम विद द थर्ड एपिसोड ऑफ सॉलिड स्टेट दैट इज पैकिंग फ्रैक्शन एंड पैकिंग एफिशिएंसी। पैकिंग फ्रैक्शन और पैकिंग एफिशिएंसी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ पैकिंग फ्रैक्शन और पैकिंग एफिशिएंसी। Packing fraction means the fraction of the unit cell which is being occupied by the particles present in the unit cell. Means the particles which are present in the unit cell, that is occupying how much portion of the unit cell, that is packing fraction. And if you express that in terms of percentage, then we say packing efficiency. Now let us look into the packing fraction and packing efficiency value of simple cubic, then BCC, then FCC cubic crystals. Okay, now let us discuss about simple cubic unit cell. This is also known as primitive unit cell. Here you see, in primitive unit cell, where will be the position of the particles? We all know now that the particles are present only at the corners. So, in this case, we'll find out the packing efficiency or packing fraction. How we will find out? We'll have to derive it. See student, first of all, in this solid state you need to imagine. So you imagine the particle as sphere or ball, you can say cricket ball, football. Then only you can easily understand the topic. Here you see the spheres I have shown in the corner of these edges. This actually, these spheres are touching each other. I could not show it in this figure. Here I am showing both the figures will be of equal size. Both these spheres will be of equal size. So here A is equal to, we can write A is equal to 2R. A length is equal to 2R. Now, how to calculate the packing fraction or packing efficiency? How you will calculate? The formula is volume occupied by spheres. Volume of spheres I am writing. By volume of cube into 100. Here, number of particles per unit cell will be 1. Since the particles are present only at the corners. So, here the volume of this sphere will be 4 by 3 pi r cube. And what will be the volume of the cube? We all have studied that volume of cube is equal to a cube. But we will put this value of a over here and we will write instead of a cube, we will write 2r whole cube. And into 100 you will do, you will be getting 52.4%. Okay, so two things we have studied in this, that for simple cubic unit cell, the relationship between edge length and radius of the particle present at the corner is equal to A is equal to 2R. And second thing, what you are studying, the packing efficiency is 52.4%. Means 52.4 part of the unit cell is being occupied by the particles. Next we'll discuss for face centered cubic unit cell. We all have studied that in face-centered cubic unit cell, the particles are present at the corners and at the face center. Here again, for opposite face, we'll put one particle. Okay. Now, you see, to derive the packing efficiency value, we'll have to do some construction. Here, you write A, B, C. Anything you can write, P, Q, R, or X, Y, Z. And you put a line over here. This is phase diagonal. Okay. Now, before proceeding, I would like to explain that here also these three spheres are actually touching each other, which I could not show in the figure. Actually, these three spheres are touching each other. So, the value of AC, you see here I have written A. The value of AC, phase diagonal, will be how much? R. Okay. So, value of AC, how much you are getting? It is 4R. Now, we will again proceed like this. In triangle ABC, this is a right angle triangle. So, hypotenuse square, AC square will be equal to BC square plus AB square. So, AC square, how much you got? 4R. 4R square will be equal to A square plus A square. This is edge length A, this is edge length A. So, A square plus A square. So, we are getting 16R square is equal to 2A square. So, we can write 8R square is equal to A square. So, A will be equal to 2 root 2R. Again, we have come to a conclusion that what is the relationship between edge length and radius of the sphere for FCC? It is A is equal to 2 root 2R. What is our next task? Next task is to find out the value of packing efficiency and packing fraction. So, for finding out packing efficiency, what we will do? We will write the volume of the sphere and then we will divide it by the volume of the cube into 100. So, here, volume of the sphere is 4 by 3 pi R cube, we all know. But how many spheres are there in FCC? In FCC, there are 4 spheres. So, 4 into 4 by 3 pi R cube divided by volume of the cube. Volume of cube will be A cube. And for this A, in terms of R, we will write 2 root 2 R whole cube into 100. Students, by putting the value of pi as 3.143, you will get 74% over here. So, what is the packing efficiency of FCC? 74%. And you can say that packing fraction is 74, means 74 part of, or 0.74 of one part, or 74 part of 100. Is being occupied by the spheres. Next, we'll discuss BCC. Body centered cubic unit cell. BCC. For this BCC, again, first of all, we'll draw where the particles will be present. We all know that particles are present at the corners and at body.
Now, here also, you will have to understand, you will put this line over here, then you will get the body diagonal. Okay, I have joined this. Now, for this, again you will do one construction, one you are putting this line for body diagonal, again another line you are putting here. It should be straight. Okay. Now you see, you are getting two triangles. Okay. Now, with anything you can mark, if you are putting here A, I am writing A. This is B, this is C, and this is D. Okay, outside this I am writing D. See, one triangle A, B, C, and another D, A, B. Two triangles are visible? Yes. Two construction I have done. Simply I have drawn here body diagonal and another I have drawn this. Okay. Now, again one thing you will have to understand, this in this body diagonal, actually the spheres are touching each other. I have not shown in this figure. Okay. But actually the structure is like this. Okay, it should be of same size, I am sorry. Okay, now you see, this is body diagonal BC. What is its value? R, 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 R. Here for the middle sphere you are getting the diameter and for corner 2 you are getting R and R. So, what is the value of BC? BC is equal to, you are getting 4R. No problem. Now you see, we will solve this. In triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, AC square is the hypotenuse. BC is the hypotenuse. ABC. BC square will be equal to AC square plus AB square. We can write BC square is equal to AC square plus AB square. Here you see, this is a right angle triangle and this is the hypotenuse. So hypotenuse is equal to, hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. You don't have any problem for this. Again you see, for this triangle I have written, for this triangle, what you can write? Suppose you are writing here equation 1. Here for this triangle, in triangle DAB. In triangle DAB, BA is the hypotenuse. So BA square is equal to AD square plus AB square. We can write. For this triangle, see, for this triangle, we are writing DAB, BA square or AB square, you can say. AB square is equal to, better to write AB square. AB square is equal to AD square plus, no, I have written wrong. AD square plus BD square. Plus BD square. AB square is this. Okay. This is the hypotenuse. This AB square is equal to AD square plus BD square. So, you are getting what? You are getting the value of AB as AD square plus BD square. Simply, you will have to put this value over here. So, what you will get? BC square is equal to AC square plus AD square plus BD square. Now, all these three are age. So, you can write A square plus A square plus A square. That is equal to BC square. What is the value of BC? 4R. So, we can write 4R whole square. So, we are getting 16R square is equal to 3A square. So you can write 16 by 3 r square is equal to 16 by 3 r square is equal to a square. So you can write a is equal to 4 by root 3 r. Again you are getting another value, another relationship, very important, you will have to remember this. Okay, now packing fraction or packing efficiency. For packing efficiency, what we'll do? We'll find out the volume of the sphere and we'll divide it by volume of the cube. The volume of the sphere will be 4 by 3 pi r cube into 2. Since in BCC number of particles are 2, divided by volume of the cube is a cube, that is equal to 4 by root 3 r whole cube into 100. You will be getting 68% over here. Okay. Now, we'll discuss next topic, that is density of the unit cell. How to calculate the density? In your NCERT book, it is given dimensions involving unit cell. So here we'll study how to calculate the density of the unit cell. This formula is very important for solving numericals. How to find out? You can write dimensions involving unit cell. Here we are speaking that we'll talk about density. Density is represented as rho. What is density? Density is equal to mass by volume, all of us know. How you will find out the density of the unit cell? We'll have to know the mass of the unit cell divided by volume of the unit cell. All of us have learned that volume of unit cell is equal to unit cell, we regard it as a cube, so a cube. But mass, for mass what you will write? For mass, you know, for mass of unit cell, we'll have to find out the mass of atoms present in the unit cell. Mass of atom present in the unit cell multiplied by number of atoms present in the unit cell. So here, for number of atoms present in the unit cell, we write Z. What is this Z? Z is number of atoms present in unit cell into mass of each atom. Number of atoms into mass of each atom. Mass of each atom is equal to atomic mass divided by Avogadro's number, 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. What? This Z is number of particles present in unit cell. This M is atomic mass and this is Avogadro's number. Avogadro's number of particles have mass equal to atomic mass. So to find out mass of one particle, what we will do? We will find out, we will divide atomic mass by Avogadro's number. So we have written this. Now for finding out the volume, what we will do? We will multiply this with a cube. Suppose here a is the h length. So we got the formula. Density is equal to Z into M divided by A cube into 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. Now, in your questions or in your solved example, you will see a factor like this written, 10 to the power minus 30. This is very simple thing, students. Usually in your questions, you will see density is given gram per centimeter cube and age length, value of age length is given in picometer. So to convert picometer to centimeter, 1 centimeter is we write this 10 to the power minus 10 and whole cube. So we get this z into m by a cube into 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 into 10 to the power minus 30. Okay, it's okay. Now you will see.